Hello and welcome to Controllers Tech. This is the 10th video in the STM32 timer series, and today we will see another application of the timer in slave mode. We will see how to use the timer in the gated mode. You can use this application note AN4013 to see the timer applications. We have already covered other slave modes, which includes reset mode, trigger mode, and combined reset and trigger mode, so today we will finally see the gated mode. As mentioned here, in gated mode, the counter clock can be controlled by the trigger signal. Also, both the start and stop of the counter can be controlled. Basically, I am going to use a button to control the trigger signal, and the timer will output a PWM wave. When the button is pressed, the trigger will go low. This should enable the counter, and the timer will output a PWM signal. When the button is released, the trigger goes high, the counter clock will be disabled and so does the PWM output of the timer. I will also cover how to automate this process, where a fixed PWM signal will be generated at a fixed rate. We will see the connection diagram in a while. Let's start the Cube IDE and create a new project. I am using STM32F446RE Nucleo board. Give some name to the project and click Finish. We will start with the clock first. I am selecting the external crystal to provide the clock for the controller. The board has 8 MHz crystal, and I want to run the system at maximum 180 MHz. Now let's configure the timer 1 in the slave mode. Select the gated mode under the slave mode. Since I want to use the button for the trigger source is set to TI1. This will enable channel 1 for the trigger, and here you can see the pin PA8 has been enabled, where we will connect the button to. I am setting the trigger polarity to the falling edge. Now let's configure channel 2 for the PWM. Timer 1 is connected to a PB2 bus, which is running at 180 MHz right now. Using a prescaler of 180 will bring down the clock to 1 MHz. The counter value of 1000 will further reduce the clock to 1 kHz, and this will be the output frequency of the PWM signal. I am using the PWM mode 2, and I am setting the pulse at 500, which is 50% of the auto reload value, therefore the PWM duty cycle will be 50%. If you don't understand the PWM configuration, watch the PWM video in the timers playlist. So this is it, click save to generate the project. Let's see the connection now. I have connected the button between the ground pin and the PA8. The pin PA9 is connected to the logic analyzer, where we will see the PWM output. Let's write the code now. In the main function, we will simply start the timer in the PWM mode. I am using timer 1 and channel 2. Let's build and run the code now. We will see the output in the logic analyzer. I have connected the output of the button to channel 1, and the PWM output to channel 2. Here you can see whenever the button is pressed, the output on channel 1 goes low, and along with it we see the wave being generated on channel 2. The PWM signal continues as long as the button is pressed, and when it is released, the signal also stops. If you zoom in here, you can see the PWM signal has a frequency of 1 kHz and the duty cycle is 50%. This is as per the setup we did for the timer. So this is working well, with the PWM signal being controlled by the button trigger. Now let's say we want to automate this process, where we want to generate the PWM signal of the same 1 kHz frequency, at some fixed rate. Before we use another timer for this, let's see the MCU reference manual. Here, if you look for the internal trigger connection, you will find a table like this. I have already explained this in the previous timer videos. Here you can see that the timer 1 is a slave to the timer 2, and it can be controlled via the signal ITR1. So we will change the trigger source from TI1 to the ITR1. The channel 1 pin has been disabled, since we are using the internal trigger now. We will use the timer 2 to generate the trigger signal at some fixed rate. Here we will generate the PWM signal with no output. This is because the output will be used for the trigger signal. Timer 2 is connected to the APB1 bus, which is running at 90 MHz right now. Using the prescaler of 90 will bring down the clock to 1 MHz. The auto reload value of 100,000 will further reduce the clock to 10 Hz. This is the rate at which the PWM will be generated. The trigger event is set to output compare of channel 1. I am using the pulse value of 50,000, which is half the auto reload value, and this will make the duty cycle 50%. This will keep the trigger signal high and low for an equal amount of time. This is it for the setup. Let's generate the code now. Here in the main function, we will start the timer in PWM mode. We are using channel 1 of the timer 2. Let's build and flash the code to the board. Here you can see the PWM being generated at fixed intervals. The time difference between two signals is 100 milliseconds, which corresponds to a 10 Hz frequency. The PWM signal is still 1 kHz, that we set in the timer 1. So we finally have a PWM signal of 1 kHz, being generated at a rate of 10 Hz. This is it for the video. I hope you understood how to use the gated mode in the timer. You can download the code from the link in the description. Leave comments in case of any doubt. Keep watching, and have a nice day ahead.